إن شاء الله we will continue with the tafsir. We are in جزء عما سورة المطففون. The stingy ones, the unfair ones, the unjust ones, the one that likes everything for themselves. May Allah forgive us. May Allah not make us like that. But before we do that, من لم يشكر الناس لم يشكر الله. We have to remember those who we are indebted to for having خير, for having goodness. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد حتى يرضى سيدنا محمد. We have to be اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد يعني thankful and grateful because Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. It is important only stingy people, only ill people, only bad people don't acknowledge when they receive goodness those who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أجر الخير على أيديهم, means the ones who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought forth whatever خير, whatever goodness on their hands. And the one whom we're all indebted to for our dunya and for our akhirah is Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, because he is معلم الناس الخير. He is the reason and the cause for us to be here even, but to be also guided. So that's why we Ahl al-Turuq, the people of Tasawwuf, who follow Mashaykh, they spend a lot of time in honoring and praising Sayyidina Muhammad. You have to be grateful. Also those who supported Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, we must be grateful for them. His family, his companions, even those who are their inheritors up to our days, who are continuing with spreading the light and love of Sayyidina Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم and the light of Islam and guidance. And yesterday, if you started Ramadan on Monday, yesterday is the 10th of Ramadan, and it is the urs of Sayyidina Khadija al-Kubra. If you started Tuesday, then it is today. And it is important to mention our mother Khadija alayha salam. We say alayha salam. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala أقرأها السلام. In hadith al-Nabi صلى الله عليه وسلم, that when Jibreel was coming and asking permission, because Sayyidah Khadija was there, and Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم gave him permission, he said إن الله, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, that sending salam, يقرئها السلام, sending salam to Sayyida Khadija. That, just this, that Allah, our Lord, unknowable, His magnificence, creator of all seen and unseen, that He specified and sent His salam through His most honored angel to this lady on earth, that Allah khassaha bis-salam. That, just that piece of information is enough to give us an indication of her status, who that magnificent woman was and is. She is from the four most honored women in creation: Sayyida Khadija al-Kubra, Sayyida Maryam, Sayyida Asiya, and Sayyida Fatima al-Zahra. Those are the masters of the heavens, of all ladies. She was the four, first, she was so honored that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khtassaha from all the ladies he created before and after. Sayyidah Khadija was distinguished and chosen to be the wife of Sayyidul Khalq, the most honored one in creation, that Allah chose Sayyidah Khadija alayha salam to be his wife. That piece of information, again, is also enough to give us an indication of her magnificence and status alayha salam. That Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala khtassaha, that she had the beauty and the wisdom and the status and the wealth in her people, that everyone in her who is anyone in Quraysh wanted to be was her husband, and she, with her tawfiq, with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala choosing her, she chose Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. And that shows you also something about her insight and her wisdom and her light with which she looks at things. That she didn't accept chiefs, she didn't accept people of wealth, but she chose someone who was young, starting his life, 25 years of age, starting not rich, starting his life. She chose him, alayha salam, alayha radwanullah. This also for us, and in yani, what can we say about Sayyida Khadija? There's no one like her in creation. Yani that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to her what he gave to her, there's nobody. First Muslima, the first. First, huh? And her love for Prophet ﷺ and her knowledge of his manners when he came and he was saying Zammiluni, Zammiluni, Dathiruni, Dathiruni, when he saw when the Wahi, the heaviness of the Wahi, and when he saw Jibreel according in his reality, and he came and he was shaking and she covered him. She said, by Allah, Allah will never disappoint you, will never cause you to be in difficulty, because you are the one who honors the guest, who looks after the weak, who looks after the orphan. Yani Sayyida Khadija was so in love with Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. This is just a sample of her manaqib. That he married her, and another indication of her status is that all the children, the progeny of Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam up till today, is from Sayyida Khadija. She bore from Sayyida Fatima, all his children except Sayyidina Ibrahim, from Sayyida Maria Al-Qibtiyya, Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad, were from Sayyida Khadija Al-Kubra. And the progeny which is still in our midst and still is a light for humanity, Ahlu Baytul Nabi, is from Sayyida Khadijah Al-Kubra. That also is enough to just reflect upon these three, four things, to know that her status as amongst the ladies in creation is cannot be exceeded. Only can be exceeded by her daughter, Sayyida Fatima Al-Zahra. Because she bid'atun min al-Nabi, she is part of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but nobody else before her or after her. Ulama, even Sayyida Maryam was most honored in her people, but in creation, سيدة خديجة الكبرى and سيدة فاطمة الزهراء عليهم السلام. This is something must be known. We must remember this. We must remember. We must be grateful. We must feel indebted. We must ask their intercession. We must ask that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala fill our hearts with their love. We must love them, because Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam loved them. Sayyidina Khadija was most beloved wife to him, alayhi salam. No one, he didn't marry anyone until she left dunya. Any other of his wives were married after she left dunya. That's how much he honored her and respected her. In an age and a time where marrying multiple, having multiple wives was the common thing. But he did not do that. So I wanted to go over this a little bit. And whatever we say, even if I stay speaking for an hour about Sayyida Khadija, we cannot give her her due right at all. But we, inshallah, we will continue with Tafsir Juz'a Amma. We have 15 minutes, I think, here until Maghrib. Allahumma salli ala sayyidina. When we reach Wailun lil mutaffifin. That Surah Al-Mutaffifun. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويل للمطففين الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون وإذا كالوهم أو وزنوهم يخسرون. Woo, woe, warning for those people. Why? Warning for those people. Which people? المطففين. What is their characteristics? Is when they deal with people, if they need something, they have a right on you, they want it 110%. But if you have a right on them, they want to give you 50%, 60%, 30%. So they're stingy. They want everything for themselves. They're unfair. They're unjust. They only act out of greed. And how much we said the world today is filled with such people. And the a metaphor of mutaffifin is the current state of the world, where it values the life of some people over the life of others. If Ukrainians die in war, 10 or 100, and no one should die from oppression or war. Not condoned, but if Ukrainians are wronged, it's not like the Palestinians, it's not like the Arabs. If Ukrainians are refugees, it's not like the Syrian refugees. Double standard, they weigh with different scales. 15,000 children killed by bombs. It's just collateral damage when they are Palestinians. But one child from different ethnicity that is acceptable or different religion, then they will not stop blowing their horns. One. So this is an example. The world we live in today is a perfect example of mutaffifin, of those people who weigh with different scale. Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. One scale for themselves, one scale for others. الذين إذا اكتالوا على الناس يستوفون وإذا كالوهم أو وزنوهم يخسرون. What we are mentioned, those who weigh with different scales. For them, their scales, they want it to be heavy. When they deal with you, they want to give you less. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَأَوْفُوا الْكَيْلَ إِذَا كِلْتُمْ وَزِنُوا بِالْقِسْطَاسِ الْمُسْتَقِيمِ ذَلِكَ خَيْرٌ وَأَحْسَنُ تَأْوِيلًا. And His order, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, is give full measure. When you measure, give full measure. When you use the scale, give full scale, full right. And weigh with a balance that is straight. Don't cheat. وأوفوا الكيل والميزان بالقسط. Be fair when you deal with people. وأقيموا الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسروا الميزان. And establish the weight with equality, with equity. Do not make the balance deficient. Don't deal with people based on your discriminatory or ideas. You know. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. ولا تخسر الميزان وأقيم الوزن بالقسط ولا تخسر الميزان. And Allah is saying, these people who act in such a way, who act so unfairly, unjustly, greedy, stingily, if you can say, don't they say think that they will one day be put on the scales themselves? Their deeds will be put on the scale. أَلَا يَظُنُّ أُولَٰئِكَ أَنَّهُمْ مَبْعُوثُونَ لِيَوْمٍ عَظِيمٍ. Huh? And that scale in Judgment Day, the scale of Judgment Day is so fine. It will not miss anything of your deeds. If Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala audits you and takes you to task, everything is going to be in that scale. Allah is saying, Allah is not يعني asking a question. Allah, it's like ta'ajjub. It's like these crazy people, these foolish people, don't they think they will one day have to stand? They will be resurrected on that great day. يَوْمَ يَقُومُ النَّاسُ لِرَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. On the day when all mankind will stand in its Lord's presence before the Lord of all that exists. Meaning Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they will be standing barefooted, naked, and uncircumcised, as Prophet ﷺ said. And Sayyidah Aisha, we mentioned this hadith, asked Prophet ﷺ, we're going to be naked in front of each other. He says, no, the matter is much more difficult than that. No one will pay attention to who's next to them. ألا يظن أولئك أنهم مبعوثون ليوم عظيم يوم يقوم الناس لرب العالمين. And this is the hadith, إذا كان يوم القيامة أدنيت الشمس من العباد حتى تكون قدر ميل أو ميلين قال فتصهرهم الشمس فيكونون في العرق قدر أعمالهم منهم من يأخذه إلى عقبيه ومنهم من يأخذه إلى ركبتيه ومنهم من يأخذه إلى حفوي ومنهم من يأخذ من يلجمه الجامع. So this hadith here that on Judgment Day, the sun will come when people are standing at that day in the Lord's presence, the sun will come so close, like a mile or above their heads of people, and people will start to sweat according to their deeds, huh? According to how evil their deeds were, they will sweat more. Some will be standing up to their ankles, they will be in sweat. Some will be sweating up to their knees. Some will be sweating up to their shoulders. Some will be covering them. تَلْجُمُهُ إِلْجَامًا means he will not be able to اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد. Up to their necks, the others will be standing. Until they are bridled with sweats, means it's covering them to their ears. اللهم عافنا. اللهم اغفر لنا واهدنا وارزقنا وعافنا. May Allah save us from such end. كَلَّا إِنَّ كِتَابَ الْفُجَّارِ لَفِي سِجِّينَ. Verily, that the book of deeds of the rebellious unbelievers is in Sijjin. And Sijjin, it is said in the tafsir that Sijjin is Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad is taken from the word sijin, means it will be a prison. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سِجِّينَ. And it is all the way down under the seventh earth, that sijin. Allahumma afina. So the record of the wicked people will be in sijin. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, and what do you know about sijin? Again, he's not asking a question. He's like a warning of what sijin contains. Those who deny Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سِجِّينَ. حديث النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, يقول الله عز وجل في روح الكافر اكتبوا كتابه في سجين وسجين هي تحت الأرض السابعة. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders the angel to regarding the soul of the unbeliever that write his book in سجين. That his book will be in Sijin, and Sijin is underneath the seventh earth. ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين. Then we brought him to the lowest of the low. إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات, except those who are believers. اللهم عافنا يا رب من سجين. كلا إن كتاب الفجار لفي سجين. The book of the wicked ones, the evil ones, is in Sijin. And what do you know about Sijin? كِتَابٌ مَرْقُومٌ. It is a specific register inscribed book. Won't mistake you. That book that is written is registered. Sijin مَرْقُومٌ, inscribed. وَمَا أَدْرَاكَ مَا سِجِّينٌ. ويل يومئذ للمكذبين. Woe unto those who deny, those who reject the call. This is like Allahumma salli ala Sayyidina Muhammad. ويل يومئذ للمكذبين. وإذا ألقوا منها مكانا ضيقا مقرنين دعوا هنالك ثبورا. So it will be, in another verse Allah is describing that when they are thrown in this very constrained and narrow place and they are chained, they will ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to destroy them, to cause them to cease to exist. كتاب مرقوم وما أدراك ما سجين ويل يومئذ للمكذبين. So don't deny those who deny, those who lie. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is threatening them. ويل. This is what's going to happen to you is horrific if you continue on your way. ويل means woe unto you. الذين يكذبون بيوم الدين ويل يوم. What are they denying? They're denying the day of judgment, the day of, they deny akhirah, they deny that they will be accounted for. وما يكذب به إلا كل معتد أثيم. Verily, the only people who will deny this is people who are transgressors and sinners. إذا تتلى عليه آياتنا قال أساطير الأولين. The ones who when we show them, when we recite for them our ayat, our verses, they will say, oh, these are mystical writings of the ancients. This is أساطير الأولين, means these are what is it, fables of the ancients. كلا بران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. Verily, what their actions and their deeds and their kufr and their denial has created a filter. Ran is like a cover over their hearts. كلا بران على قلوبهم ما كانوا يكسبون. It is a run that prevents, like something that prevents hijab, like prevents light. For example, if you put something to prevent the sunlight from entering, run is something that covers. كلا بران. What happens? Why our hearts become covered with, so that the light of truth, Allah's blessings, Allah's mercy, does not enter it? What covers it is sin, is the deeds. The more we are engaged in sinful actions, the more that filter will become thicker and thicker until we are unable to discern. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgive us. كَلَّا بَرَّانَ عَلَىٰ قُلُوبِهِمْ مَا كَانُوا يَكْذِبُونَ مَا كَانُوا يَكْسِبُونَ. What they used to earn made this filter over their heart to cover their heart. اللهم عافية. إن شاء الله tomorrow we will continue with the daily program. ومن الله التوفيق بحرمة الفاتحة. Thank you, Sheikh Colombo and family. Thank you, whoever joined us and said Salamu alaikum salam. Barakallah fikum. Inshallah, we will continue tomorrow. Salamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.